Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sam and this video is about gallbladder ultrasound reporting. We will look at gallbladder pathologies and see how to write reports for each pathology. This will include clinical indication, findings and impression. We are only focusing on the gallbladder, so other organs reports will not be in this video. This is not a complete abdominal ultrasound report. The first case is cholelithiasis or gallstones. The clinical indication in this example is abdominal pain and bloating. In the findings, you can write the number of gallstones, whether it is single or multiple. The stone or stones are seen as echogenic structures. This is suggestive of cholelithiasis. Then you can write the measurement of the largest stone if there are multiple stones. And then you can write about gallbladder wall thickness. This is the impression for this example. Cholelithiasis with multiple gallbladder stones, including a 1.5 cm stone in diameter. Clinical correlation is recommended. Always add this line because diagnosis is not only done on ultrasound alone. Now we will look at WES sign, which stands for wall echo shadow. It occurs when the gallbladder is completely filled with gallstones. In the findings, you can mention the thickened gallbladder wall and the multiple echogenic foci within the gallbladder. That will be consistent with cholelithiasis. Then you can mention a well-defined curvilinear echogenic structure along the wall of the gallbladder with a corresponding acoustic shadow consistent with WES sign. In the impression, you can write cholelithiasis with multiple stones and the presence of the WES sign. Clinical correlation is recommended. For gallbladder sludge, the clinical indication can be abdominal pain and nausea or follow-up of cholecystitis. In the findings, you can write about the distended gallbladder, the thickened wall, and what it contains, as sludge appears echogenic with layering dependent to gravity, that is consistent with gallbladder sludge. In the impression, you can write gallbladder sludge with thickened gallbladder wall if there are no gallstones or biliary obstruction. You can write this line and then you can write clinical correlation is recommended. Now we will look at acute cholecystitis. The clinical indication can be right upper quadrant pain, fever, elevated liver function tests. In the findings, you can write about the distended gallbladder with wall thickening and the measurement of the wall. Then you can mention the presence of pericholecystic fluid. If there is sludge or gallstones, you can write about that. In the impression, you can write findings are consistent with acute cholecystitis, and then you can mention the presence of sludge or gallstones, and then you can write about pericholecystic fluid. You must write correlate with clinical and laboratory findings. And then you can write this line about medical management. The clinical indications for gangrenous cholecystitis can be right upper quadrant pain, fever, or leukocytosis. In the findings, you can write about the distension of gallbladder and its thickened walls with no clear interface between the outer edge of the gallbladder and the liver. Usually the walls are irregular, so you must mention that, and it will show signs of necrosis with areas of wall disruption and ulceration. The gallbladder lumen contains echogenic bile and there are no visible gallstones. This is in regards to this case. In the impression, you can write findings are consistent with gangrenous cholecystitis. You must write urgent surgical intervention is recommended because this is an emergency case. For gallbladder perforation, the indications can be abdominal pain and fever. In the findings, you can write about the distended gallbladder and its thickened walls and mention the pericholecystic fluid. If there is echogenic material in the lumen, you can also mention that. Then you must mention the disruption of the wall and the location of the disruption. In this case, it was the body of the gallbladder. And then you must write the presence of fluid in the surrounding area. If fluid is seen outside the disruption, in the impression, you can mention gallbladder perforation with pericholecystic fluid and debris. The disruption is seen at the body. And finally, you must write urgent surgical intervention is recommended. For gallbladder polyp, the indication can be abdominal pain. Usually, the gallbladder is normal in size and shape. You can write this line, and after that you can mention a polypoid lesion is noted in the gallbladder lumen, and then you can write its size. Usually the polypoid mass is echogenic, so you can write this, and these masses have a smooth surface and appear to be arising from the gallbladder wall. No shadowing or enhancement is noted posterior to the lesion because it is a solid lesion without calcifications. And then you can write about the gallbladder wall thickness. In the impression, you can write a polypoid lesion and its size. And then you can write features consistent with a gallbladder polyp. And finally, you can write about clinical correlation. Here is a case of adenomyomatosis. The clinical indication is abdominal pain. In the findings, you can write about the distended gallbladder with thickened walls and containing multiple echogenic foci with comet tail artifacts consistent with adenomyomatosis. And then you can write about gallstones or if there is any pericholecystic fluid. For this case, the impression was gallbladder adenomyomatosis with comet tail artifacts without evidence of cholelithiasis. Now we will look at gallbladder cancer. The clinical indication here is suspicion of gallbladder cancer. In the findings, you can write a large mass occupying the gallbladder lumen The mass appears heterogeneous and has irregular borders. And then you can write about gallstones or sludge. In the impression, you can write the findings are highly suggestive of gallbladder cancer. And further evaluation with CT or MRI is recommended. You can write these statements in the impression. This is a case of porcelain gallbladder. The indication was right upper quadrant pain. In the findings, you can write a thickened, echogenic, and irregular wall with focal calcification. These can be the findings for porcelain gallbladder. This is the impression. You can write porcelain gallbladder with or without the evidence of a mass. And then you can write recommend correlation with clinical and laboratory findings and consideration for cholecystectomy given the risk of malignancy associated with this condition. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe and stay tuned for more imaging videos.